In this video, I show how to set up the radios and add or remove software licenses. In the previous video, I read the radios and created a configuration. So to set the radios up, I need to go to Manage, and then Configurations, and then choose this radio configuration that I read. To edit it, I need to click on the pen button. Firstly, I'm going to rename this configuration and I need to go through the settings. Now, most of these things are not relevant to Capacity Max, so I'm just going to go through and make sure everything is okay. Remember that every time you click away from any set, Radio Management is going to prompt you to save. So that's why you see these save prompts coming up every so often. Oh, one setting you may be interested in is the TX power. Now, I wasn't careful, and you'll see that I encounter a problem in a few minutes. One other thing you may want to look at is to give the radio user access to certain things in the menu. There's nothing in signaling systems that's relevant to Capacity Max, so I'm skipping that too. However, what I am interested in is the contacts and the RX group lists. Here is something a little unusual. In Radio Management, you can have a single contact which could have different MDC, Select 5, Digital, and Capacity Plus IDs. Also, you need to have at least one contact that has all of these added, otherwise you'll get a validation error. The other entries don't have to have this, so you can see that I already have four talk groups that were added last time this radio was set up. Now when I come to RX group lists, you will see that there are already four entries that were created last time this radio was set up. I suppose I could have done a factory reset, but that didn't occur to me at the time. The RX group list in Capacity Max works exactly the same as in IPCI Connect and Capacity Plus. When the radio uses this list, it will watch for traffic from any of these talk groups listed here. The talk groups you see here come from the contact list. Next, we come to Capacity Max features. Here, it's relatively easy because a lot of the settings have been done in the previous video. First up is CapacityMax Systems. Here, I simply need to replace the existing set with the one I had created in the previous video. There is a set already there from the last time the radio was set up. So I just delete this, then right button click and choose an existing set. Choose one and click OK. And that's it. Next is CapacityMax radio wide features. Once again, all you need to do here is to select an existing set that will replace the current set. The same for site selection. Select an existing set. When I do that, it tells me it's going to replace the current set. Click yes and OK. I'm not going to be using emergency for now, but here in emergency systems I have to put something even though it's not used. Then, for status list, I once again select an existing set. Now we come to the interesting part, zone channel assignment. It's pretty much like the zones in the CPS. You'll see here that I have two zones. Zone 2's only got some arbitrary channels, so I'm going to delete it. So right button click and select delete. Now, when I do that, it says, okay, if you're going to delete, you're going to remove some things that are referenced elsewhere. So I'm going to ignore that. And you'll see what happens when I come to validate the configuration. Now let's go to the first personality in Zone 1. You'll see that there are already some existing CapacityMax personalities. These were created last time the radio was set up. I'm going to keep those and change them to work on the current system. If this was a fresh radio, you would have to click on the plus sign and add however many CapacityMax or other personalities you need. So let's look into the first personality here. I'm going to give it a memorable set name. The channel name is what will be displayed on the radio screen in this case. There are some other settings you can change here if you want, but the settings I'm interested in are group list and contact name. These work the same as in IPSiConnect and Capacity Plus. You can set in-call criteria to whatever you want, but I'm going to use polite. Lastly, you need to select a system. So click Browse and select a system this personality will use. Then I need to go back to the zone, and if I do that, radio management will prompt me to save. Now, you will see that I made a mistake. The set name is duplicated, so I have to go and rename the zone. I'm going to go through and do the same thing on the other personalities here. And I'm going to go through this quickly because, well, it's kind of boring and pretty much a repetition of what I've done already. Scan lists, capacity plus site lists, and RX group lists are also not needed for capacity max, so I'm skipping them too. Now that I've created this configuration, I need to now go and apply this to the other radios. So what I do is I select all the radios and right button click and choose select configuration. And now that configuration is applied to all of them. Now that I've done that, you will see that the first little block in the modification column has changed color. This means that I have changed the configuration of that radio, so I should write it back. Now before I do that, I'm going to go click on Analyze. And when I do that, Radio Management's going to check the radio configuration. And, as you can see here, it found some errors. There are essentially two errors. One is the power that was not set correctly, and the other relates to the scan list members. So I can go and click on Actions, and this will reset the power value. Then for the scan list, I can't reset anything, so I actually have to go there and fix the problem. The problem was that when I deleted Zone 2, it deleted the channels but didn't remove them from the scan list. So it's just a case of deleting them. So now I can go and run Analyze once more, and you'll see that the radios all come up green. I'm going to write the updated configuration to the radios. I'm going to speed this up, otherwise I'll put you all to sleep. Okay, so now it's done. I'm just going to go through and just check that everything is okay in RadioView, but there is nothing missing there and everything seems okay. Then I'm just going to go across and look at everything in the system view, and there everything seems okay too. So now I can move on, and I'm going to go and restore or add licenses. So let's go to Manage, and then Licenses, and then Capacity Max System Server Licenses. You will see that all of the licenses are supposed to be in the server are there now. If this was a new system, I would normally go in and I would add the licenses through the window here by clicking the plus sign at the top. But I've already activated the licenses, so instead I need to go to Manage, Settings, Licenses, and then Restore the license. If I click on Task, you will see that it's contacting the server. So at this point, you need to be connected to the internet. So now you can see the licenses that were there are now available for registration. Next, I'm going to go do the same for the radio licenses, and to get a nice view of what is enabled, you can go click on the Features button at the top, and instead of just displaying the serial numbers, it shows a list of licenses. So I click on the Capacity Max license here, and you will see that the licenses have already been purchased and activated, so nothing else is needed here. If these radios were new, you would have to add the licenses. These radios were already programmed on a Capacity Max system, so there's no need to redo the licenses now, so I'm moving on. Here you will see that because I've restored the licenses, I now need to write this updated configuration back to the CMSS. Once I've done that, then the system is almost ready for use. All I have to do is to check the subscriber access control, and that I'll do in the next video.